Aloo Gobi, which translates to potatoes and cauliflower in spices, is one of the most incredible Indian subcontinent main or side dishes. It's full of so much flavor, and best of all, it's so easy to make. Please sit back, relax, and enjoy. All right, guys, to start us off, here is half a large cauliflower that weighs 500 grams or 1.1 pounds. With this, we're just going to slice around the core to separate the cauliflower pieces into florets, and with the core, this is fantastic for soups. With the florets, we can then cut them into bite-sized pieces depending on the size of your cauliflower, just until you have something that looks like this. Next, here is three large washed potatoes with a combined weight of 650 grams or 1.4 pounds, and after peeling them, slice them in half, then slice each half into quarters and then come through and dice them into bite-sized pieces, just like we did with the cauliflower. Moving on, grab two large ripe tomatoes and we're going to do exactly the same process as we did with the potatoes, cutting them into quarters and then dicing them into bite-sized pieces, just like so. Now this is optional, but here is one long green chili to create some spice to this dish, and with this, simply slice off the stem to save it for a compost if you'd like to, and then slice the chili in half, leaving the seeds in for additional heat. The next ingredient is one large lemon to add a tasty acidic finishing touch to this dish, and the only step for this is to slice it in half, saving the other half for another dish or drink, and then with the remaining half, we're just going to extract the juice towards the end of the recipe. Then last but not least, here is half a bunch or 20 grams of coriander or cilantro to which we're going to give a good old rough chop, which doesn't have to be too fine, and this is going to be used to finish off our dish. Now to get this cooking, place a large pan or pot onto your stovetop over a medium heat, and then once hot, add in 2 teaspoons or 10 grams of clarified butter or ghee and allow it to melt. Once melted, add in the diced potatoes and sauté these for 5 minutes to slightly soften them, stirring frequently. Also, during this recipe, the order that the ingredients are added is going to greatly enhance the flavour and outcome of this dish, as each ingredient really does have its own key role. Now 5 minutes later, the potatoes can then be removed from the stovetop and transferred to a plate or bowl for the time being, and then set aside. We can now place the pan or pot back onto the stovetop, and whilst it's still hot, add in 1 teaspoon or 5 grams of clarified butter or ghee, again allowing it to melt, and this time add in the cauliflower, which we're going to sauté for 4 minutes, stirring it frequently to slightly soften it up. Also, the reason that the potatoes and cauliflower are kept separate is because they both cook at different times. After 4 minutes, remove the pan again, and then tip the cauliflower onto a separate plate or bowl, again popping it aside for the time being. Now here's where the magic starts. Whilst the pan's still hot, add in another 2 teaspoons or 10 grams of clarified butter or ghee, allowing it to melt again, and then add in 1.5 teaspoons or 3.5 grams of whole cumin seeds, and then with these, we're just going to toast them off for 1 minute or until they start to crackle, and this is going to let off the most amazing earthy warm flavour. After 1 minute, we can add in 1 thinly sliced large brown or yellow onion and sauté these for 3 minutes, stirring frequently. What we're looking for here is the onions to really break down and become extremely soft, and the moisture from them is going to slightly deglaze the pan, pulling up any bits that you may have lingering around, creating even more amazing flavour. Once the onions are soft, add in 3 cloves of freshly minced garlic, which is going to give us that warm, deep flavour that we all love, as well as 10 grams or 0.3 ounces of freshly minced ginger for a fresh and sweet flavour, as well as an amazing aroma and fragrance. Once that's in, continue sautéing for 1 minute, stirring frequently, just for both the garlic and ginger to very slightly cook and start to release their flavours. Now 1 minute later, add in the diced tomatoes, which is going to give us moisture and help this all come together, the split green chilli for added heat if you're using it, 1 teaspoon or 2 grams of ground turmeric for a colour and fragrance, 1 teaspoon or 2 grams of ground red chilli for a warm heat, half a teaspoon or 1 gram of ground coriander for citrusy floral notes, and 3 quarters of a teaspoon or 1.5 grams of ground cumin to increase the depth and flavour of all of those spices. Now that that's all in, continue cooking this for 5 minutes, stirring it frequently to break down the tomatoes and bring out the most incredible flavour combination within those spices, or like we say, allow those flavours to become friends. Okay, so now after 5 minutes and the tomatoes are soft, we can then reintroduce the potatoes that we sautéed earlier, giving them a really good mix through that flavour combination, making sure that they're completely coated in those spices, then place a lid onto the pan or pot and allow it to cook over a low heat for 6 minutes. Once that's done, remove the lid and give everything a really good mix, and I will also say, if it happens to get a little bit dry, at any stage, just add a splash of water to help it out. Next, we're going to add in the sautéed cauliflower, as well as 3/4 teaspoon or 1.5 grams of garam masala, which adds a beautiful spice blend of sweet and aromatic flavors, and then season this with 1.5 teaspoons or 7.5 grams of sea salt flakes. Give all of this a really good mix, making sure that the cauliflower is completely coated in all of that flavor, then cover this again and cook this for 15 to 16 minutes or until the potatoes are soft but not falling apart, and also give it a really good mix every 5 minutes or so. After that's done, squeeze in the juice of the halved lemon, catching any seeds that might decide to jump in, and the acidic flavor really brings out the most amazing fresh taste. We're then going to add in the roughly chopped coriander or cilantro, which adds an incredible fresh fragrance and flavor and really tops this off. Then give everything a really good mix until the coriander or cilantro has been evenly distributed, and then turn this off the heat and remove it from the stovetop. Now to serve this up, you can do it however you'd like, but I like to pile this up onto its own plate or bowl and then top this off with some more coriander or cilantro for more freshness and flavor. Then once that's all done, we're then left with this beautiful dish that has the most incredible spice combination, which adds amazing flavor, freshness, and color. And then all that's left to do is make this all worthwhile, which is that we can then dig in. So there we have it. This recipe right here can be used as a main or a side dish, with both ways being incredible. It serves 2 to 4 people, depending on how hungry you are, and it can easily be doubled, tripled, and so on. As for storage and reheating instructions, along with serving ideas, I'll leave all of those details in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to smash that like button so my channel can be seen by more people, and consider subscribing along with hitting that bell notification next to it so you never miss when I upload. Thanks for watching, everyone. Stay safe and enjoy.